Yeah, what's going on, y'all? It's iPodKingCarter here, the Superman of YouTube. Hold up. Madden? On iPodKingCarter channel? Get the fuck out of here. I'm just playing with y'all, man. Awesome. I got a smaller... This nigga really talking? What's up?
Now, do your thing. Yo, do your thing, man. Do your thing.
Hey, can I introduce you at least, guys?
Do your thing, man.
Hey, what's up, y'all, man? I got a nice little interview today, man. I got my boy WyzaNow in the building. You already know what it is. For all y'all fans out there that love Madden, that don't see it from me, myself, I want to point you guys somewhere into a nice direction to my boy WyzaNow. WyzaNow, introduce yourself.
The chicks know who I be. I was loud, right?
He was dumb loud.
I just got real close to the mic.
Freak ass boy with this Yeti, man. Look, man, a lot of people been asking me in my inbox, on Twitter, on Facebook, on Google Plus, on Tumblr. They all been asking me, iPod. I'm everywhere with it, man. They been asking me, iPod, play some Madden. iPod, where's the Madden? iPod, do Madden. iPod, I need Madden. iPod. I'm like, man, I can't provide it. But what I want to tell y'all is I got somebody that can. Now, I got a couple questions for you, Waza. Questions just to give you guys an idea of where this guy's head at is in Madden. Now, first question. We all know, when me and you first started this YouTube thing, we was heavy on 2K.
Oh, man, we were. Like, when I started my channel in 09, I started out doing All-Pro Football 2K8, but... You know, I didn't know there was a YouTube. Like, I didn't know what YouTube was. I was just posting videos for the forum guys to see. And then I stopped until 2011. But once I started in 2011, oh, man, 2K galore.
Yeah. Now, I just got one question. Recently, of course, if any of these viewers that know you have noticed that you made a small transition from 2K to Madden. And we would all like to know why.
I wouldn't even call it a small transition. I would call it a huge transition. Like, I completely eliminated it. But the reason behind that is because I had Madden and I had 2K at the same time. And I was still playing 2K, putting out 2K videos and really not putting out any Madden videos because I wasn't really too interested in it. I was never really a Madden fan. I always liked 2K, especially 2K football. So when I had to play Madden, I'm like, I need my football fixed, so I gotta play Madden. And what happened was my 2K, I guess my Xbox was finally starting to get up there in age. I had my Xbox since like 06. Same exact Xbox.
Still had a dinosaur,
yeah,
by the way.
Yeah, the white joint with the 20 gig. I had that.
That's the same one I got, don't hate.
Maybe yours is in better shape. Who knows?
Man, my mic don't even work. I keep getting new controllers and my mic don't even work. I think it's the Xbox.
Need to get you a new app. But look, so what happened was whenever I would go to play my player, I would get to, like, say, a few minutes into the first quarter, and I would just, the red rings would pop up all the time. Red rings. So, but when I put in a different game, it worked perfectly. So.
Okay, also, for all you PS3 fans out there, if you don't know, that's the red rings of
gonna
death.
Go that route with it. We're going to go that route.
Yeah, yeah. I got PS3 fans, man. Shout out to them. But the Xboxes have an overheating problem and the red rings happen, but usually just due to faulty hardware, but we're not going to get into that anymore.
That's what we're going to do with it, huh? I'm just going to soil my system, huh?
Yeah, had to. But moving on, explain more about what happened with 2K and your transition to Madden.
All right, so I fell back on the 2Ks. You know, I really tried. It had even gotten to a point where, you know, you, Carter, was making the videos for me, and then I would just go and edit them and put commentary on them like they were my videos. Oh, and so I'm like, man.
That's supposed to be your secret.
Nah. So I'm wondering, like, man, people really don't know, you know, people don't really pay attention to my videos because, one, you would know I don't have a PlayStation. Two, you would see iPod King Carter's name in the beginning of the video when he's doing the team select. People didn't peep that. And, you know, and I had gotten to a point where I'm like, you know, this has to be frustrating for you to play a game that you're not even going to be uploaded. And then you got to put it in the drop. That's taking up space in the Dropbox. It was just becoming a large task. Plus, you know, I couldn't enjoy playing the game myself. So I started doing a little Madden, and it caught on pretty well. And it was fun because I was playing Ultimate Team. And what Ultimate Team is, you start off with a crappy team, and you collect cards. And the cards that you collect, you know, it makes your team better. You collect better players all the way down to legends. And you play with those guys on your team, and you play with that team online. And it was
because five Calvin Johnsons.
Yeah, right. But I'm not that type. That's not me. I'm not that type of guy. I wouldn't put that many Megatrons on my team. Maybe two.
Maybe two. All right, man. Next question, man. So how's Madden treating you so far?
It started off very good. Madden started off for me very good as far as like my subs watching. It was really good, especially with the Ultimate Team. But then I kind of like fell back a little bit because I started getting my daughter a lot more, so I couldn't do as many videos. Plus, I wanted to gain a football sub base. But the problem that I had was I was doing it during the off season of football, so football was
too late.
Yeah, football is over. You know, it's dead. Super Bowl is over, and when the football season ended, so did the views. I mean, I tried doing the franchise mode with the Broncos, not because of Tebow, but because I like you know, the variations of their uniforms. And it was like, it was a struggle to get views. And as time went on, it got even worse. It's like, yo, football. Like,
who you got to kill to get some views?
Who I got, yo? Who I got to stick my mushroom tip in to get some views? That's what I wanted to know. But I'm still trying, man, because I really like football. I'm a football guy. I love football. You know, I like basketball. I'm not going to say I love basketball. I like basketball. I suck at 2K.
But you love football. You deliberately say you love football, but can't stand basketball.
Yeah. And also, you know, WWE as well. I love WWE, and that's why I do WWE videos as well.
This shit on all my NBA fans. Thanks a lot, brother.
No, I said I like it.
That helps. Man, moving on.
Look, man, okay. Dwight Howard wants out of Orlando. I'm pissed. I can't even follow my own team. All
right? You're right. But, all right, since you already said that you were trying out the Ultimate Team and Franchise mode, what else are you doing with Madden? What other modes do you play?
I play online franchise where I have a online franchise where I invited my subscribers. I tried to keep
playing with the subs.
Yeah.
That should get a couple people here right there. But he playing with you guys, man. I'm just saying. And there's not a lot of people out there that do this.
I tried to keep it with you know, the subscribers that frequently visit my videos, that, you know, their names are familiar. I opened the door to those guys first, and then I opened the door up to more subscribers that just so happened to catch my video that may have been straggling along. And It's tough running a franchise because you have to deal with so many different personalities, you know, and these things have to mesh, and you also have to consider everybody's schedule and all of that. It's a lot of work to run that franchise, to keep involved with subscribers, and this is one of the best ways to keep involved with the subscribers. But you know, and also to do the videos and to do the comments, it's a lot. But it's fun because, you know, it keeps me in tune with the subscribers. It's a lot of fun, you know, going back and forth with them, but it is a lot of work.
A.K.A. Feedback Junkie.
Feedback Junkie. Dang, I ain't used that phrase in so long. I haven't heard it in a while either.
Yeah, man, we've been doing this a long time, man. We've been Feedback Junkies for how many months now? Goodness gracious.
For over a year now.
Oh, man, don't even remind me.
Been doing it.
This is crazy. Okay, all right. Another question. All right, now you know I'm a diehard 2K player.
Right.
I got one question. Is there a My Player mode in Madden?
There's something like a My Player mode. There's something called Superstar mode.
So you're just going to shit on the name, too,
and
huh?
It's... It's straight Dookie Ball, Dick Butter, ass juice. Like, it's bad, man. I'll tell you what it is.
So I shouldn't make a transition either?
No, not for that. Maybe if they do something with it. Here's what you can do. With this type of mode, and this is something that 2K should do if it had a 2K, NCAA 2K. What they do is you can take your Road to Glory player from NCAA and you could put them into Madden. So it's like you climb the ranks in college, and then he goes into Madden, and you know you start your superstar mode from there. Or you could create someone, or you can pick someone that's a rookie in superstar mode, just like create a create a legend.
Oh, so it's all molded into one.
Yeah,
that's kind of hot. So you can bring it from NCAA.
Tell you what's wrong. Yeah, that's the good part of it. Okay. But after
so
that,
you could be like an 80 overall, maybe.
They'll still start you off pretty low. Even if you come out as a 99 overall from NCAA, all your stats will be maxed out. You'll get into Madden and be like a 70.
Oh, okay.
So you still got to work your way up, but relatively, after about 5 games, you're already like 85, 90.
Okay. Right, that's not bad.
That's not good. There's no work behind it.
Well, yeah.
Because I'll tell you why. There's no training mode to it. There's no drills. All it is this mode is just straight skin and bones. It's you play the game, and if you choose to, you can practice. If you choose to.
Wow.
That's it. No drills, no endorsements, no team up, no nowhere you could take your created player, nothing. Absolutely.
So basically, that's the Madden 12 is like 2K12 in my player mode. You can't do shit with them but play games and offline. That's basically
all
what
offline,
it is.
All offline, but you can't even do as much as you do in 2K. No, all you do is play the game, period. That's it. End of story.
Oh, shit. And if you don't make it to the playoffs, it's a wrap. That's it.
That's a wrap. I mean, you can... You can get traded to any team anytime you want during the season. You can't even... you play offline. There's no online mode to it. There's nothing you can do with your superstar. And when you do play offline, all you do is play the game. That's it. You play the game, and they have like a cam on you where it's like... I don't know if they did it this year in Madden, but I know in the previous year in Madden, it's like a superstar vision. Where you, it's like first person.
Oh.
Or they'll have the camera behind you and it's only focused on you, which is cool, but you can't really see, you know, the majority of the rest of the field unless you're the quarterback. And if you're the quarterback and you throw it down the field, the camera stays on you. So you can barely see down the field.
Oh, no, that's ass.
It really is. And there's no drills. There's no endorsements. There's nothing. This thing is pretty bare. It's just you play the game, move on to the next game. Play the game, move on to the next game. Jordan ain't going to be sending you no contract.
Oh, no, I can't have that.
Let me change that. Jerry Rice ain't sending you no cleats. Jerry Rice ain't sending you nothing. So,
that's pretty bad.
Yeah, it's not a mode I'm looking forward to.
This is mostly the biggest question on probably everybody's list. That have been listening to this up until now. Are you done with 2K?
Not done with 2K, man.
Say it again?
Not done with 2K, man.
I ain't hear that clear.
Look now, damn it.
<You're> For everybody that wants to know is why is it done with 2K, the answer is no. The reason why, let me hear it. Come on.
All right. Me and you went to battle so many times in private conversations about me being done with 2K, and I was so done with 2K because it destroyed my Xbox, and I didn't have any fun playing it when I did play it because it was so different from 2K11. Getting familiar with the control of your player, such as like the bumping animations and the bad passing and the computer just being like, come on, really? For example, Kobe Bryant. You know where I'm going with this.
No, don't talk about it.
You know where I'm going with this.
Listen, we don't talk about those type things on comms.
You know where I'm going with this now. Kobe Bryant will sit there at the top of the key and just keep doing crossovers, and you can just be standing there minding your business, not touching the analog. Not touching. Right, right. Don't touch the analog. Kobe still... Kobe will run the shot clock out. He'll take the shot clock violation. As soon as you touch, if you touch your analog stick, you're done. That's when he goes by you. If you don't touch your analog stick, I promise Kobe will probably take the violation.
Yeah, he would.
But then say you get Kobe on your team. You pass him the ball and do an isolation with him. Let him iso to himself. Let him do his thing, right? Let Kobe do his thing. He won't do none of that.
Nah, not at all. He on your team now. Why he gotta work?
See, that's the problem that I have. And that's the problem that I have with 2K. That's why it wasn't fun to me. Like, Dwayne Wade and LeBron, they will go off on you if you ain't on their team. On the way off.
Listen, in my player mode, LeBron averaged 30, Dwayne averaged 27.
And now, I'm playing my player. I'm on the Heat.
I'm on the Heat. If you can't beat him, join him, right?
Can't beat him, join him. Dwayne Wade can't make a layup to save his life.
What happened to his AI?
I pass him the ball. I call an ISO just for him. He go between his leg one time, two times, and now he don't know what to do no more. He just hold the ball.
What the fuck happened?
LeBron plays like LeBron, but he misses everything.
All the jump shots.
Unless he's if he's wide open, he got it.
Got it. But nothing contested. He ain't clutch like Kobe.
No. The one thing I can say about LeBron.
What's his name again? LeBrick?
LeBrick. Definitely LeBrick.
Okay.
The one thing I can say about LeBrick is he'll go for alley-oops all day. You throw it up, he coming down with it. He coming down with it all day. That's LeBrick right there. That's his tendency, I guess.
I seen your little montage. Nice work.
Hey.
I'm going to have to save my damn self.
See, look. The funny part about it, this video will come out eventually. Once we do it over. Why is my phone ringing? I'm not ready to answer it. This video will come out because we got to do it over. He watched me play it live, and I'm ass. He knows I'm ass. I was complete ass juice. But, I don't know. Like, I played it a little bit after, and I was in, like, I was just in just full grind mode. And I had, like, I don't know how many dunks. I'm like, you know what? I got to make this game into a montage just of me going off because I really went off.
It's only right. That between the leg jump, oh, my God. I was almost threw my computer at the wall, dog. I said, God damn. This,
yo, like, that dunk package? That dunk package cray. Is the way.
Cray. That shit is cray, dog, from the rip.
I love that dunk package. I wish it had some more in it, but...
I need to ask Ronnie2K, is it J.R. Smith or is it Josh Smith? I don't know who the fuck it is, man.
Yeah, it just says J. Smith, right?
Yeah, I thought on J.R. Smith's name, it has the R in it. So I'm really not sure what's up with the world, man.
Yeah.
So one of these days, I'm going to have to tweet him and be like, yo, what's up? But look, we done went far left. We talking about Madden here.
Right.
What are your hopes for Madden 13?
I just farted. Did you hear me fart?
Nah, I didn't hear you fart, but...
Damn.
Tell the fans.
All right. My host for Madden 13, I have a video up that I just put up along with my montage. And it's called, what's the name of that video?
Superman. Come on, man. You know it got something to do with me. Come on.
You think that was for you, huh? But the name of the video is, this flying Superman glitch bullshit better not be in Madden 13. And this is one of the problems where I have with Madden 13 is the linebackers can literally fly. They should just put capes on the linebackers. They can jump 10 feet in the air to intercept you. They could jump across the screen. Literally, across the screen. They can fly. I promise you, they can fly. Like, the AI for linebackers. It's no other positions. Only the linebackers, and it's been this problem for years. The linebackers' AI is just through the roof.
What you mean? It's on 173%. You didn't know?
Yeah, I see. I absolutely see.
That's just like the centers this year. You can't get past the centers. The centers going to block your shot every time you go to the rim.
That is.
It don't matter. It don't matter who they are, dog. The centers can keep up with a point guard with 99 speed.
Yo, and that brings me to another thing. They have to fix, I guess, like the AI when it comes to hawking somebody down that's going for a touchdown. And they got somebody chasing them. They could have a 340-pound defensive tackle chase down somebody like Arian Foster or Maurice Jones-Drew or Chris Johnson. Now, this is like a guy with like a 40 speed catching somebody with a 99 speed.
Shit.
All the way down the field. They got to do
something. I feel sad for them.
Come on. They got to... Come on. Try to be a little bit realistic. A little bit. So can I patch up the gameplay?
All right, let's do this. Can I get a top 5 wishes for your Madden 13 wish list right here, right now?
All right, I'm right off the cusp because I have never done a wish list for anything. First, I'm going to have to say the AI with the linebackers is number one.
Okay.
Number two is the blocking system. The blocking is horrendous still. They fixed it, and it's still horrendous. Next, I'm going to say the online league websites. You should have a lot more control for the online league websites, such as being able to restart a game, being able to control, not control, but being able to have commissioners of leagues approve trades.
Okay, okay.
Number
four.
Let's see. Just a lot of... Oh, number four. All right. Let's see. Damn.
So much shit.
A better way of, like, with the online ranked games, just a better way to evaluate the opponent before the game. Like, you want to be able to see their record. You want to be able to see their did not finish. You want to be able to see, you know, their skill level before you get into the game. Because if you just go into a lobby and randomly challenge someone, you don't see anything until you go to challenge them. And then you're already stuck in there.
Yeah, you're bad. Then you catch the L if you quit, huh?
Yeah. Well, why is it don't quit?
Well, no, I'm saying, but that's my habit, right?
Yeah. You definitely catch that L.
Oh shit! All right, number five, last one. What you got?
Bring more variety to the modes, such as Superstar and Franchise. Give us a little something more to do. Back in the day, with Superstar, they used to have a house. They used to have a cell phone. They had email. They had drills. They had all of that stuff, and they just pulled it back.
They had iPhones and mansions.
They had iPhones and mansions. for anybody that ever played the Def Jam series, the Def Jam fight joints? You know what I'm talking about?
Icon and all that.
Yeah, but not Icon. I'm talking about like the first ones. You know how you had the house. And then you had the two-way pager. They'll call you on it just like in your midnight club. They'll call you on your joint.
Oh yeah, on my side.
They had that in Madden. Something I would like for them to take from 2K, which is 2K5. They had the cribs and they had a trophy room and they had your accomplishments in the trophy room. And also like with the more trophies you get, you had to do certain particular things to unlock the trophies. Like, say, get this amount of sacks with this particular person, or get this amount of touchdowns by this time. You know, the same way they got that list of things in 2K?
Milestones.
Yeah, the milestones in 2K5 and 2K football, and just in 2K basketball, I believe they had the cribs too. They had the milestone trophy room inside your house. They also, inside your house, like, there was an upstairs and downstairs. They had a TV. You could deck out your house. You could go upstairs and you had a game room. You could play pool. You could play darts. You could play all this different stuff. I would love to see these things implemented back into the game. Stuff that was in the last gen.
You know, they were creative early in the game.
Yeah, but they just started repackaging. Yeah, once the competition died, once the competition was brought out, it just went downhill. They didn't have to be creative anymore.
All right, last and final question of this con. What are your plans for Madden 13 when you get it? And are you going to get it on a release day, a.k.a. 12 a.m.?
I'm not 12 a.m. in it. Hopefully, I can get it before release day. Layla's back in here, and she's giving me mail, so that means we got to hurry this thing up.
Hey, last question. You did it.
Okay, so...
so basically, in Madden 13, you're going to have franchise mode.
I'm going to have franchise mode. I'm doing the online franchise. I'm going to try out Superstar mode to see if it's any good. You probably was able to hear all of that in the background.
Yeah, it's all good. The subs will be real, people.
these are your subs. Your subs love you, so I'm sure they love anything with your voice on it. Hey, hopefully they'll check me out. But don't want to self-promote. But yeah, if there's a upgrade to Superstar mode, I'm going to be all over that as well. I'm going to try to tackle as many modes in it as I can, but whatever can get me to interact with the subs a lot more, those are the ones I'm going to attack the most. But, of course, I'm still going to have 2K in there. I'm not going to do it as much as you. So I don't want people thinking I'm going to do it as much as you.
Hey, man, and I got to do what I got to do, man.
But it's still going to be there, but, you know, I'm going to tackle this Madden and this WWE 12, man.
All right.
So that's the plans.
All right. Well, of course, you already know.
Also, I'm going to be the info man, too, the info man for 2K.
IKC system?
Yeah, I'm IKC system in it. I'm going to be the info man. Like, everything, every piece of news that come out, I'm going to be all over that.
All right, y'all heard it here first, man. My man Wise is gonna be on his info shit. He getting that Madden 13. He's still doing 2K. He doing his WWE 12 thing. So you already know what it is, man. I just want to thank everybody for watching this video. You already know what it is. Hit me up on Twitter. Why is it telling where they can see you at?
Finally got me a background for my channel. So I have links for everything I use on my banner, such as my Facebook, which I seldomly go to, my Twitter, where I always interact with the subscribers on Twitter. I got a lot of followers, but anybody that hits me up, we always get the back and forth going. And right here on YouTube.
Y'all heard it here, man. Thanks for watching, everybody. Saki C signing out. Peace.